Hey.
Any catastrophes happened while I was gone?
No. Disappointed.
What? What's the matter?
It's that dress.
Oh, well, it's getting so warm outside that I stopped at Kate's when I was in town, and I decided to change into something more summery. Do you like it?
No, it's very nice. It's just reminded me of a skirt that Tricia had.
Oh. Well, I'm sorry. I had no idea. I'll go change.
Don't bother.
Oh, hey, Curtis.
The outfit may look like Tricia's.
But there's nothing else about you that remotely resembles my sister.
Leo will be here any minute.
Good. Then maybe we'll get to the bottom of this once and for all.
Why do you insist on going through with it?
What's the matter, Jeremy? Afraid of a little truth?
Moi? Far from it.
The truth is that we never slept together, so all your little test is going to prove is exactly that.
Sorry to disappoint you. The test will prove you're not pregnant, not by who you did or did not sleep with.
It'll prove that you're wrong, and that's all that counts.
That's all that counts. I see.
Oh, please. Please, don't act like the sage old professor. You don't know everything.
I know one thing. You're getting in too deep to ever get out of it. Well, you stop this charade and tell Leo you don't love him. That's the truth.
All wrong, Professor. Leo is all the man I need.
But not for a husband. Promise you, you married a guy, you'll get bored to death and begging for a divorce within a month.
I don't beg. Leo, sweetheart.
Leo.
Honey, I'm sorry to drag you out like this in the middle of the day, but Jeremy won't take no for an answer. He keeps insisting on taking this DNA test.
Oh, am I in the right place?
Oh, yes, I'm just borrowing Dr. Daly's office. Come on in. I'm Lisa Hellman. I'm a genetic counselor.
Shana Vojcik.
Oh, please sit down. I've just been going over the results of your amniocentesis.
Now, there's something unusual. I know Dr. Daly told me. Now, what exactly are we dealing with here?
Well, first of all, don't just automatically assume the worst. It's quite possible you'll have a perfectly healthy child.
Depending on the results of further testing, I know. Dr. Daly told me that, too.
You're worried?
I'm terrified. I didn't sleep at all last night. I kept hearing the words normal and abnormal bouncing around in my head all night long, hour after hour. I need you to tell me something definite, something that I can hang on to so that I can prepare for this.
I understand. And I will do the best I can. But if you're looking for a guarantee, then I'm afraid you're going to be very disappointed. Results of your amnio revealed that the fetus has what's called a marker, which is, an extra piece of genetic material.
Yes, yes, yes. Now, what does that exactly mean for my baby?
Well, it's a little too early yet to find out how it's going to manifest itself.
Well, where does something like this come from?
You know, we really don't know. But we do statistically know that markers appear in only one out of maybe 2,500 amnios. And out of those markers, the risk of abnormal things happening is like 10 to 15%.
Well, that makes me feel a hell of a lot better. Look, can we just dispense with this wonderful word, abnormality, okay? Now, what are we talking about? Birth defects? Retardation?
Yes, possibly, but you see, that's why we do all these blood tests, and then we do a DNA structure on both parents. And if either one of you or both of you have the same marker and it's a healthy and normal, well, then the chances are that the child will be healthy and normal, too.
But if neither parent carries this marker?
Well, if it's new to the fetus, then the chances are that the child will develop problems.
Then what?
Then you have a decision to make.
Abortion.
Yes, but you see, we found it early enough in the pregnancy so that you can terminate easily and safely, if that's what you choose to do. But you know, there are other options.
I want this baby so badly. You don't know what I've gone through. The idea of terminating, I can't even think about it.
Well, no, you don't have to, and you shouldn't. Not until all the tests are completed. Look, let's not go any further until we have all the facts, okay?
Right. Right, the facts. Do I do the test here?
Yes. So, why don't you get the father down here, and I can arrange to have you done together.
The father?
Tests. I hate tests. All because Jeremy has to prove he's so smart.
Well, maybe it's the best thing, Ava. Then we can find out for sure, huh?
Listen to me. Honey, I'm sure. I know for sure. I can tell you absolutely, positively right now that Jeremy is not the father of my baby.
Absolutely. Positive.
I don't think I would lie about something like that.
But you miscalculate.
No, I don't think I could miscalculate about something as important as that.
Leo, don't you think you'd be better with the certainty of science? I know I would.
It's my body, okay? Mine. You got it? Honey, I know these things. I really, really do. Trust me.
Ava Rescott? You're Ava Rescott?
Well, Dr. Daly, don't tell me you don't recognize me. I mean, after all, you've been treating me for 2 months now.
Well, so it would seem, but I must be getting old. This doesn't even look like my handwriting.
Ah, yes. Your associate, Dr. Pliny, saw me the last 2 times when you were absent.
Well, that must explain it. Well, I have a patient called Allison Rescott, but...
Ah, yes, my niece. We're often mistaken for one another.
I see. Well, I delivered Allie's baby last week, but I honestly don't recall treating you.
I find that hard to believe. She's not exactly easy to forget.
If you leave, you take your company's business with you, and I'll let them know that, too. What's your name?
Thelma.
Thelma, you're going to spend the night here until every surface in this office is spotless. Is that clear? On second thought, you do seem oddly familiar.
Ah, yes. Perhaps my hair was...
Can we discuss this DNA test, please, Doctor? What exactly does it involve? For you, gentlemen, it's simply a matter of drawing some blood. For the mother, we need to do an amniocentesis to get fetal tissue for comparison.
Well, is there some sort of risk involved here?
There's always a small risk to the fetus with an amnio, yes, which is why I'd recommend waiting until after the baby's born. Unless it's absolutely necessary to determine paternity now.
Oh, I don't want to take any risks. Maybe we should just wait.
Oh, Leo, thank you, sweetheart. See, that Jeremy's going to have to wait.
If only I could.
Excuse me?
Well, normally I would never put the life of a child in danger, but you see, the agency just assigned me to a mission in the Far East. I'm leaving immediately. I never return. But if I'm to be the father of the child, I think I should know so I can tell them that I can't accept.
You better tell them you can accept.
Ava, the man has a right to know.
Fine, gentlemen. You obviously leave me no choice. My baby and I will have the test. Dr. Daly, can you make the arrangement?
Very well.
Good. But can we first draw blood from these two? Lots and lots of blood. Is there any way I can assist?
How's he doing? He's still fussing up there a little bit?
Oh, he just wants his dad, I guess.
Here's my big boy. All right. You and Tess met, right?
Yeah.
At Kate's.
Yeah, I meant to ask you, how is it over there? Are you comfortable?
Yeah, it's very nice.
For now, maybe. Right, Tess?
Why do you say that?
Oh, I don't know. You just strike me as the type of woman who aspires to something much greater.
Not me.
Oh, yeah? A lot of ambition in this girl, Trucker. She'll leave us in the dust before we know it.
Oh, I don't think so. Taking care of this little guy is about as much as anybody can handle. He's still crabby?
Yeah, just a little.
It's nap time.
Oh, you're right.
Here, let me take him upstairs.
I got him. I'll take him up.
Okay.
Could you just maybe fix a bottle for later?
Sure.
If you get a chance. Thanks.
Come on. Why are you giving me such a hard time? I'm not hurting anybody.
Not yet, anyway.
You used to trust me.
That's a mistake I don't plan to repeat. It It's gonna be all right, Tess. I'm never gonna let him hurt you again.
There's nothing you can do.
I can hold you tight.
You shouldn't be here. If he finds you here, he'll kill you.
I'm not going. Unless I know you're okay.
I'm never gonna be okay as long as I'm stuck in this place. And since I'm never gonna get out of here, please, you just gotta go. You gotta go and save yourself.
Tell me this. Do you love him?
No. No, I used to, but I don't love him anymore. He's different here.
Then what I see is an American being held against her will. He can't stop you from leaving.
Sure he can. He can kill me.
I will not let that happen.
What can you do?
I've got this buddy who's a helicopter pilot.
Well, well. Would you look at this? It's reunion time. Found our friend.
You could have fooled me. I thought you didn't want him to know.
Nice try, Slick. Last time I talked to her, I knew I'd need help getting her out of town.
Yeah, and a lot more than money. Take the $5,000.
You gave her $5,000 to leave town?
And an airline ticket. Guess I should have thrown in a job, too. Someplace far away.
I like it here, guys. No husband beating me here. Just sweet little babies and quiet nights at the boarding house.
Oh, yeah, it sounds downright domestic.
A road jockey like you wouldn't understand. Take the money and the ticket. You'll need it.
Not anymore. I'm home.
Are you? Well, did you mention to Curtis why you picked Charming Corinth as your retirement home?
He already knows Trucker's my half-brother.
Well, that makes three of us. Maybe it's time to tell Trucker.
Maybe. But that might raise some questions you might not like answering.
Like why you're here.
Well, I hate to disappoint you, but Trucker already knows why I'm here. You're the big question mark.
Tess?
Yeah? You need me with Chris?
Could you just come up for a second? He's still uncomfortable,
sure.
And now he feels a little
okay,
hot. I think
I'm
he's
coming.
Running a fever or something. I'm sorry.
What the hell are you two cooking up, and why did you bring her here?
I didn't bring her here. Now, calm down. I'm on your side.
Sure.
I told you Tess was here, didn't I?
Then why don't you tell me what she wants?
I hadn't figured that out yet, but you can bet she's up to nothing good. Now listen, if we work together...
Not a chance, Buck.
Curtis, look, I know you don't care much for me. I don't care much for you either. But if we work together, we can get rid of her.
Well, the sooner the better. Because I can't stand her being around my nephew.
I feel the same way about Trucker. He doesn't know what he's in for.
Well, he's 99.4. It's not much, but if he's catching something, maybe we gotta...
He's warm. But look at all these blankets. I mean, maybe he's just... I don't know. He's got too many blankets here. It's nice outside today. Maybe he's just crabby because he's hot.
Think so?
Well, let me pick him up.
Where's my other cot?
How's that, Chris, huh? Is that better?
Where's my other cot?
Hush, little baby, don't say a word. Mama's gonna buy you a mockingbird.
I should have thought of that.
Why?
Because I'm his dad.
Well, you can't be super dad.
I know, but I mean, if I forget something that's really important...
You love Christopher. Just... He knows you love him.
Hey, you.
You're not going to forget that. And that's all the child could need, huh?
I think maybe he just needed a woman's touch.
Maybe he just wanted me to pick him up.
I know he really misses...
He
misses his mom.
Well, we can't replace her, but we can give him a safe, secure home and surround him with people he can depend on. Everybody needs that.
Yeah, everybody does.
Yeah.
Right?
And he's lucky because you're a great dad. You are. And if that mockingbird don't sing, Mama's gonna buy you a diamond ring. And if that diamond ring don't shine, Mama's gonna buy you some peace of mind.
Oh, well, if it isn't my two dads. That was fast.
Well, relatively fast and painless.
Ooh, unlike the test that I'm gonna have to take.
I hope it won't be too difficult for you in there.
Oh, thank you so much for your concern.
Dr. Daly said that he won't do anything to jeopardize the child you're carrying.
Yeah, he wants to be very cautious since there was a little confusion as to your earlier appointment, so he's going to give you a full physical before the amnio, which I think is very wise.
Very, very wise.
Thank you. I'm so glad the two of you are in such agreement about what's good for me.
And your baby. Dr. Daly's waiting for you.
Leo, sweetheart.
What?
Now that your part of the test is over, you can go home.
Oh, no, no, no. I'm going to wait for you. I want to make sure that you're all right, Ava.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
That's sweet. Excuse me.
Leo, I know this is awkward, but I think it's best that we have it all out in the open, don't you think?
Well, I can see how this could affect your decision on this Far East assignment of yours, but see, I can't imagine the result changing the commitment I feel for Ava.
Leo, you're trying to do the right thing, and I admire you. Hope one day you'll realize that I'm trying to do the right thing, too.
How did you find out? Did Dr. Daly tell you?
About what?
The amnio.
Well, you told me yesterday. You said everything was fine, that the test was just routine.
Then you don't know.
Shana, no what? What did you find out?
Leah, would you hold me?
Whoa, Shana, take it easy. I'm right here. What is it?
There's something that I have to ask you.
Anything, go ahead.
How would you feel about... I'm sorry. Would you excuse me?
Shana, wait. How would you feel about what?
Some other time, all right?
Leo.
Yeah.
I have some very important news for both of you.
Look, the longer she stays, the tougher it's gonna get. Trucker's already dependent on her.
I can see that. Look, she's got her own agenda. We just have to figure out what it is.
You sure you didn't help Tess put this together?
Curtis, look, I'm not looking to help her bust you, all right?
Look, the hell with me. What about Trucker and Chris? Look, if she gets her claws into him...
Hey! How's our little future biker mechanic
he's
doing?
He's okay. He's okay. All he needed was a little fresh air or some attention.
All right, where'd it go, Pop?
It wasn't even me. It was Tess figured out the whole thing. Another minute or two, I was going to be calling the hospital. She knows just what to do with him.
So, Tess is working out?
Yeah, I'm really lucky I found her, to tell the truth.
How was it that you found her again? In Maine?
Yeah, I just ran into her in a doctor's office up there.
Did you, check her out at all?
Can I ask you something? Do you know something about her that I don't know? I mean, you made the remark before about her being nothing like Tricia. I just don't... You said something to me the other day. What's this all about?
I just miss my sister. I know that nobody's going to be able to replace her.
Well, I know that, too. It's just I need some help, that's all.
Hey, look, you still got your family, Mom, me, Dinah Lee.
Yeah, me too, Trucker.
I know that. Listen, I haven't forgotten it, and I thank you. I appreciate it, really. If this makes you feel any better, you guys, I did call the school where she used to work, and they loved her. I mean, but I tell you the truth, I would have hired her without any references, I think.
Why?
Because references just tell you what she's done, you know? I needed to know who she was, you know, and what she's like inside. And I think the only way you can do that is in person.
What's she like?
I think she's a very special, good lady. And she's just what my son needs.
mockingbird, don't sing. What am I gonna get you? Mama's gonna buy you a diamond ring. But you'd rather have a truck. Wouldn't you? You and me, we need the same things, don't we, Chris? Yeah, we need a place where we feel safe. Where no one can hurt us. We need a place where we're surrounded by lots of love. I think that we found it. I think this is it, don't you?